to a Who's Accountable report. Emergency officials spent 10 hours rescuing visitors who had crashed their hot air balloon in the wilderness. But after all those hours of overtime, some viewers want to know who's accountable for paying the bill. 16 WAPT's Catherine Kite tells us, and she took those questions to authorities.
Madison and Yazoo counties are both stuck with the bill after Sunday's 10-hour search and rescue on the Big Black River. Investigators say low fuel and a quick change of wind sent a hot air balloon crashing down, stranding three men. Now, some taxpayers say the pilot should be accountable for the search and rescue cost.
That's it. If I go and wreck my car, you think I look for the taxpayer to pay
it? They know the risk when they was going. They took a flight up in the balloon.
If I was to go take a balloon up and I knew the risk, I wouldn't expect somebody else to pay for it.
Emergency crews we talked to say they have no intention to ask for any money back.
I'm sure there's a lot of cost involved with overtime and so forth, but these guys are on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and that's part of their job.
Madison County is actually putting more of its funds into the Emergency Operations Department because with a growing population, the director says there's an increasing need for their services. County supervisors say that money for upgrades is coming from extra tax dollars, some of which comes from your phone bill. Emergency Management Director Butch Hammack says the county is also using the money to update the 911 system and add more vehicles.
The quicker you get on the scene, the quicker you get information, the quicker we can recover.
Hammack says that's what happened Sunday and ultimately why these men were rescued. Reporting from Madison County, Catherine Kite, 16 WAPT News.
Madison County will vote August 1st on adding more funds to the Emergency Management Department.